Morning, garden lovers. Welcome to my garden on this bright and sunny morning. This video I'm going to focus on how to get basal shoots from your roses. I did have some requests from my last video when I showed them my roses and the growth from the base. They did ask me how I got them, so I'm going to show you today what I use. But first I'll show you some of the shoots that I've got from these David Austin roses. Well, most of the roses I have basal shoots this year, and I've never actually had so many. This particular variety is Bring Me Sunshine. This year it just seems to be a little bit more paler than last summer, but this is the first bloom. Maybe when it matures, it becomes more of a deeper yellow. At the moment, it just seems to be like the inside of a banana, whereas I was expecting more of the outside of a banana, if you know what I mean. Say like this picture here. It is quite orangey looking, but in reality, it's not that brassy looking. It's more of a brighter yellow. Very tall bush, quite relaxed habit, and super fragrant, this one. Very, very fragrant. But I'm going to show you some of the canes I have on this and what I've been feeding it. Look at that. That's behind that, that's a brand new cane. Gorgeous. I'll show you some more before I get to the products that I've used. But this is a lovely one of my favourites as well for the fragrance, Bring Me Sunshine. This one here with the bright red foliage, intense brownish red colour, very, very glossy. This is a Cordes rose called Spicy Parfuma. So the purpose, well, not the purpose, we welcome new canes because when these grow from the base, these are ones that carry the new flowers and the new growth. We're able to remove some of the older canes here so that these can take over. So, you know, new basal shoots are very, very welcome sight indeed. Here is the cutting of my Jubilee Celebration that I got from my brother's garden. This is about a 3-year-old cutting, and I have managed to get a new cane from this as well. Look, very, very nice. I have heard people say that Jubilee Celebration is the colouring is similar to the new launched yesterday from David Austin, Emma Bridgewater. It's like a vintagey muted pink colour, blends with a little bit of apricot, and a new cane from a cutting too. How great is that? Here are some more growth. Like I said, a lot of the roses do look like that this year, which is quite unheard of for me. Probably due to what I've been treating it with this year. Not only that, a lot of top growth from what I consider to be not a very strong rose. This is Benjamin Britten. Gorgeous, gorgeous flower, but it's just not a very healthy rose. But as you can see, what I've been feeding it with have created such a strong growth as well. This one here is Princess Alexandra of Kent. Beautiful big bloom. The bloom are usually big, but unusually big this year because of the feed. And the growth on here, the canes, are amazing. So when these mature, I would take out the older canes, probably this one here. But fantastic. Now some roses are better at getting new cane than others. This one here is the beautiful Munstead wood, discontinued. Gorgeous, gorgeous deep red, deep red crimson colour. Beautiful. As you can see, even with all the feed, it's still quite not as strong growing as the other roses. So I could see why they've discontinued this one, because I don't think they can get it to be as vigorous as the new varieties. This one here is also an older variety. This is, as you can see from the label, is Scepter Dial. This new growth from there as well. Beautiful. Oh my goodness. This is not a great look. Not a great look. This is supposed to be my standard tree, Chandos Beauty, but as you can see, it's so lopsided. So I just don't, I'm not sure how to prune it. I'm not great at growing. This is only one of two standard roses that I have. But it's growing really well. It's just really lopsided. I need some help from Dilly. There's a lady that grows a lot of standard roses, and I need some help. Okay, we reached to this main content of this video on how to get basal shoots, or how I did it with these products here. Now in spring, I've added this chicken pellets manure to all my plants. This is a very gentle feed, so you can't really overdo it. I just randomly scatter, and I also added chicken pellets to the compost mix, and just rake it in. But I think the main thing from what I've done differently is using this product here, this top rose. It specifically, it says it's rose and shrub, so I fed all my roses with this. What I do is in spring, in about March, I mixed in this these white granules here. They look, oh my goodness, they look like that. And I mix it in with the soil and some manure. So it's just so it's, if you pre-mix this, you're not likely to get in clumps when you put it around the rose base. So not to, and not to overdo it. So I mix it in with the soil first, and then I would mulch it, a layer, then layer, mix it in over the rose bushes, and then mix it in with the original soil, and then remember to water it in. So this is what the product I use, and I've checked out some of the some other rose feeds, but I did find this one is actually very high, higher in potassium oxide than most. This is quite a high nutrient feed compared to some of the others, which was in similar price. So this is the product I use. Now I also use as a feed. I use this about twice a week, and I add it to my watering can, and I water the roses like a top up with this on a weekly basis. So these are the products I've used that I've haven't done in the past, and this is how I got basal shoots from all my roses. And they seem to have grown a bit better this year, possibly because it hasn't been so dry, maybe the conditions. So I'm not quite sure whether that's the weather has affected the growth. I'm not really great on watering because I'm away from home quite a few days of the week. We shall see in the later summer if they become a bit more dehydrated. But these are the products I use. So let me know how you get on to see whether these have improved your roses. I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye.